It's that awesome time of the week where the Bleach anime website updates and we get some interesting news on the most upcoming episode, being episode 5, getting some awesome previews of some images of what's going on throughout the episode. And of course, just like the rest of the episodes, it seems that we are going to be getting some little previews of the first half of the episode rather than the second half. So the second half is always up to speculation on where the episode is going to be ending. And boy, does this episode look like a treat? So please stick around for some awesome Bleach upcoming anime news. So as per usual, you are going to be getting some images throughout the video showcasing what we're going to be looking forward to within next week's episode. But before I give my impressions on them, I do want to quickly give you the synopsis of what this episode is about, essentially. The Shinigami are relieved to hear that Ichigo is on his way to the rescue, but in the Garganta, Ichigo is trapped by Kurage Opie's ability. Just when the communication with the Technical Development Bureau seems to have been cut off, the voices of the Shinigami are heard. Amidst the echoes of rage, screams, and despair, Ichigo hears these words. Meanwhile, Byakuya takes the initiative before Asnodt, who has taken his own bankai, and orders Abari Renji to determine the enemy's abilities from the battle. So, if you're a manga reader, you already know that there is going to be some amazing stuff within this episode that we all hope is going to be done right, especially with the Rukia segment. If you haven't been keeping up to date with the channel where I do give Bleach news, we did speak about a few months ago how something such as Rukia, for example, is going to be getting a little bit of extra screen time in comparison to the manga to find out who essentially attacked her. And considering that we have on the team or on the staff list for this episode, it seems that Haramitsu that is doing the script writing is going to be the one in charge of this episode, which is something that tells me, of course, if you guys don't know Haramitsu, is that they are more inclined with adapting novels. And considering that we are going to be getting things that are not in the manga, so to say, it makes sense that these ideas from Kubo given to Haramitsu or even to Gucci are then penned down and then made into an anime adaptation. So this is probably one of the perfect episodes that is good for Haramitsu in this given situation, considering we are going to be getting a little bit of extra things with Rukia and maybe some other things in general. We don't really know, and that's the exciting thing, is I'm very interested to see where the script writing is going to go for this episode overall, and of course that this is also one of the last episodes of where we get to see the final cuts from the PVs that we've seen over the weeks before the anime airs, such as, you know, Renji blocking a bunch of Zenban Zakuras, and maybe even Yamamoto Genryusai's little wall of fire. Because after this episode, it will be all entirely new content that we haven't seen before, especially from the PVs in general, so we're going in completely blind from that point on. So I'm very excited, and I think episode 6 is the one that I think people are anticipating the most, because we are coming up to an extremely big battle. And as I said in my review, if you haven't watched that as well, this episode in episode 4 seems to have been setting up Byakuya versus Asnodt, which seems to be the case considering this synopsis, and we're going to be getting that in this episode as well. So I expect some really good fight scenes, which we also saw from the PV as well, some good choreography with Byakuya and some good choreography from Renji as well. I believe that this episode is going to be extremely not only action packed but also very horrific as well. I'm also interested to see if they remove or keep any stuff in from this, because again, we have a lot of things from other stormwriters getting involved, and I'm also excited to see if they're going to start implementing little bits of hints in regards to, you know, what these stormwriters' powers are. For example, in the anime yet, we have not been told what Kurage Opie's powers is, which is the jail. Each of the summaries has like an alphabet, and each of those alphabets mean something. So for example, Kurage is the jail. And in saying that, in the manga, the way that we knew about these abilities was usually at the end of a chapter via a doodle, which I'll show on screen, for example. So I wonder if the anime is going to kind of express these abilities or express these illustrations to give the audience an idea of what these abilities do. Because Kurage is, you know, on his last legs, and it seems that he is going to be partaking from the anime for now. So it would be interesting to kind of throw in there. Though in saying that, I wonder if they're going to throw it into the title cards in between the episodes as well, like they've been doing. So I hope they really don't miss out on that, because it is kind of vital information for the audience to know as well, that each of these stormwriters do has an ability and, you know, in a sense what they do. I think not saying anything as of now has been good, but since as one of the stormwriters is about to kind of partake, it would only make sense that you kind of reveal what his ability is. In regards to the images that we've got, there's some amazing images that we've been getting. The Ichigo trying to fight against the jail, him stressing out, him hearing the voices that we got in the synopsis. The stress and anguish on his face is really telling here, and I can't wait to see how that is going to be looking. We then then see Rukia screaming out to somebody. We'll see who that is as well, but we saw this in the PV and this cut in general looked gorgeous. We have Byakuya looking as stressed out as he has ever been, and the most discomforted, if that's a word, that he's ever been as well. Throughout the entirety of the Bleach series, I've never seen Kenpachi lose his composure like this before, so it really shows a lot of what's on stake here and how serious Asnodt is as an enemy. We get a nice shot of Renji, nothing too telling here, but the one thing that does interest me a lot is the camera angle, so I'm very excited to see where the director of this episode is going, the storyboarding of this episode. I'm really excited for that. And then towards the end of our list of images is Kisuke, Chad and Orihime getting their own little spotlight here, and they look shocked to see something. I know what that something is. I wonder if they will show what that something is. If you are an anime only, I'll hold off on what that is, but if you are a manga reader, do not say in the comments what it is. But for my manga readers, I will say I'm interested to see what they will do here. It was kind of hidden, but it kind of wasn't at the same time. So I wonder how Kubo or Taguchi or however they've devised this plan and how to incorporate this this specific reveal or conclusion, so to say. I don't know how to say it other than that. I'm very interested to see how they handle it. So I'm very excited for that. But if there's anything to go by from this episode as a whole, like the staff looks strong. This episode, you know, has a lot going for it. It really has a lot of potential. And I'm excited to see where it's going to end. I imagine that it is going to end on some, you know, Yamamoto. That's my prediction. I think the horror aspect really needs to be delved in. And I mean, it needs to seriously drive home. Because the horror aspect, especially with Ichigo and hearing the voices, Byakuya versus Asnodt, even Rukia here, you can see the fear in her face. This episode needs to strive for the horror and despair moments. And that's what this episode should incorporate. That's what its main core focus should be, the horror aspect. Other than that, I'm really excited. I want to see if anything gets expanded on. I want to see what gets cut. This is an exciting experience for this episode and I'm very interested. So, with that being said, what do you guys think? What do you guys want? What do you guys want expanded on? With that being said, though, I am going to catch you guys later. Please hit the like and subscribe. It helps a lot. And of course, I'm going to catch you guys later. Peace out.